Hey, hi, it's Craig, and I'm going to do a djembe tuning tutorial, the finer tuning using a kind of a billy club. You can use whatever you like. You can use a baseball bat, you can use a leg of a chair, or a tree branch. I'm going to show you all the methods, and hopefully you have some idea of how to tune your own djembe. Let's get right to it. See, like this. Just gonna show you where we're going. You take your rope, taking these two, going under one, over two, and under one. He's doing this one-handed. Pull that all down. Back under two. And I'll just put new rope on this, completely new rope. I've done it twice actually because the first set of rope wasn't strong enough. This is a calf skin, quite tough. So that's it, you get this S shape. So over two, under one, back under two. Get the billy club. Billy club, billy club. Wrap it around, lock it. What we're doing is we want to get all the slack out of the djembe. Over two, under one. Take out the slack, back under two. I might get a screwdriver in a minute. Help me along with this. Get your stick, lock it. Slack. So, this is my favourite club, but you can use anything. You can use just a piece of tree. Over two, under one, and if you haven't got tough fingers like I have, just use a pair of pliers to pull it through.
Thank you.
you get to the end, when you've been all the way around, this is your starting point. There, starting point for this row. These two ropes, which is the end of this rope, essentially, you count as one. Okay. So you're going underneath this knot. Run it down. Just behind them two ropes there. It's essentially one line, it's coming down from there. So when you take two into consideration, you're taking three. Always trying to get the rope down as far as you can. That's where the tension comes in. I'm taking all the slack out every time. And then, so this is the end point, beginning point for the next row, which in my view, you should always go round, all the way around. At least on the first row anyway. So when you've got back to your starting position, sounding pretty good, you're looking for the next two ropes that you're going to be working with, which is these two. Rope that's going over, so it's the opposite to the ones you've been working with. This gives you the diamond shape, but this is the correct. So away, so over two, number one, really tight now. So, the reason I always do another one is once when I pass this drum on, then the person that I'm passing it on to has got a reference point for where the next row is going. I might do another one, sometimes I do two. I'll probably do two on this because I'm not actually going to see the guy, so. He lives far, far away. This drum will be going via courier. So you see, you can't really tell by that almost, you know. So if I do another one, you should get the reference points that it's the ones that are going over the rope you should be working on next. Probably getting tight this now.
Bye.
pretty obvious now that's the way you're going. And the next two, leave that up to the client whether he wants to put any more knots in it or anything. So that's it. Always have plenty of spare rope on it. Tune it up. Some people like going about three or four up here to get it really tight. But personally, I'd like that to settle now and just play it for a while, let it bed in, some new skin. Don't tie it in a knot, just wrap it under three times and pull it. There you go, that's how you get the diamonds in. Pretty good. Thanks for watching. That's how you tune the djembe, fine tuning. You can go round and round, keep going round and round. Don't forget to press the subscribe button and the bell to get updates of all my new videos.